imagine how many miles these guys traveling around all day without a map, without a GPS, just in a blind hope to find something to eat, someone to mate with. Then they find a big white foot like this. What is this good for, he thinks. Nothing at all, my friend. Nothing at all for you. What to do with this guy? Now, if you've seen Bear Grylls, you know that even guys like this is full of protein, and they can easily be eaten. But I'm not Bear Grylls, and I'm not really that hungry, and I try not to eat anything that has been alive. It's not something that I'm extreme about. Sometimes if people are cooking for me and it's not possible to communicate with them, you know, they already made the food, I eat it. Try to go around the meat pieces, but sometimes, you know, it's one big mix. But I never buy meat of my own, and actually I've been living for this now for as long as I've been in Africa, so almost 5 months as a vegetarian. Or a flexitarian, as some call it, because I'm not extreme. And I feel good about that. Sometimes it's hard in restaurants to find anything to eat at all. It's not at all a part of the culture down here to not eat meat. But it feels morally good. It feels like the right step in the right direction of becoming the man I want to be. Wow, this fellow is really persistent. He keeps coming back every time I throw him away. Ah! Angry little guy. Come here. What do you want here? There's nothing for you here. But anyway, the vegetarian thing, it feels, as I said, like a step in the right direction of becoming a peaceful person, of becoming the best version possible of myself. It's, in a way, it feels like I always wanted to be, you know. It has just been a cultural thing to eat meat, and something that you don't really question. But then living on the finca in southern Spain, Finca La Sacristia, where it was a vegan place and it was a normal part of the culture not to eat meat, then I realized that it's actually a possibility, and it's possible for people to live a healthy lifestyle without, and instead of asking why do you not eat meat, it's more natural in a way to ask why do you eat meat, right? I mean, it's kind of a bizarre thing to do. to eat other dead beings. It's not that I think it's disgusting. I love meat. I miss a big juicy steak. But really, if you grew up in an environment where it was not the normal thing to do, I don't think it was. It will be something that you will just have a craving to do. It's the same with smoking, right? That if you never smoke in the first place, if nobody smokes, it's not something that you will feel attracted of doing. And I feel that eating meat is killing other beings for your own pleasure. And I'd just rather be a person who don't kill anybody for my own pleasure. Even though it's lower intelligent beings and all that, I know those things, and it's not that I say that everybody who eats meat is evil people or anything. I'm that's not what I'm saying. I just say that for myself, in my own paradigm, I have crossed that line of consciousness where I no longer feel raised above other beings just because they are less intelligent than myself. In the furthest consequence, we could also start talking about human beings being less intelligent and not having the right to live from being that. I mean, who are we really to judge who is intelligent enough to have the right to live? Maybe there is more intelligent powers out there, more intelligent civilizations out there in the universe. And according to this philosophy that we are entitled to to have meat factories and use other living beings for our own pleasure, for clothes, for food, for testing of things, will that entitle them also to keep us humans in slavery and use us for whatever they see fit? I know for many people this sounds like some extremist vegan stuff, but I'm not really trying to be extremist. It's just a thought that I have had the time and possibility to think through for myself doing all these days and hours on the road, and inspired of the people in the Finca, and it's something that feels good. So I'm happy and proud of becoming a vegetarian or a flexitarian. Because I can still eat meat, I just don't want to be the one deciding that this is what we're going to have. I know for some vegetarians or vegans this also sounds like not good enough, but I'm not really trying to satisfy anybody but my own believes with this, and I'm happy with my choice. I can easily make my own judgments from time to time, and as long as I feel good and just about it, that's all I need. Wow, that was a long speech about vegetarian stuff. It was just supposed to be about my little camping here, but I guess it's good enough to turn those stones also. Now I will get some breakfast and get moving.